Well, Batman's fighting Superman thanks to Lex Luthor, Lex Luthor. Harley Quinn's causing a bunch of trouble in town with the Joker, in town with the Joker. Cheetah's taking all of the power away from Diana, cause we'll have fun, all Snyderverse Summer's here. Fun, Snyderverse Summer's here.
What's going on, guys? On this episode of On the Set for the Snyderverse Summer, I'm taking a look at the Black Adam movie starring Dwayne Johnson. Back in 2600 BC, a tyrannical king had his people as slaves mining for a metal called Eternium. He used the metal to forge the Crown of Sabbac, which is said to give him great power and invincibility. A young boy, tired of his rule, stands up to the king and tries to stage a revolt. After doing so, the young boy is chosen by the Council of Wizards, along with Shazam, who transforms the boy into a powerful being. Then, the boy uses the power to kill the king and end his rule. Now in present day, Kahndaq has become overrun by crime, thanks to an organization called the Inner Gang. We meet an archaeologist named Adrianna, who is trying to locate the Crown of Sabbac, along with her brother Karim, and a couple of colleagues. They manage to get inside a tomb and find the crown, but some of the Inner Gang thugs kill one of her colleagues. After reading an incarnation written on the crown, Adrianna accidentally awakens Teth-Adam from his slumber, the father of the boy with the powers. Adam then makes quick work of the gang, showing off powers of his own. After hearing about this, Waller sends in the Justice Society to apprehend Adam, feeling that he is a threat. The Justice Society consists of members Hawkman, Cyclone, Atom Smasher, and Dr. Fate. Once in Kahndaq, they pursue Adam and tell Adrianna that he's actually a killer, not a hero. Just then, Adrianna's other colleague, Ishmael, is revealed to be not only the leader of Inner Gang, but also the last relative of the king from the beginning of the movie. So, Ishmael kidnaps Adrianna's son, who hid the crown somewhere in town. The Justice Society, Adrianna, and Adam follow Ishmael and give him the crown in exchange for her son. But Ishmael tries to kill her son anyway. Adam then kills him before he can. Then Black Adam explains to Hawkman that his son was actually the one who the wizard had chosen, but his son was killed by the king's assassins. The wizards then gave Teth-Adam his power, and he uses it to kill the king, becoming blinded by rage. After this, the wizards deemed Adam not worthy of the power, so he killed them too, all except for Shazam, who imprisoned Adam along with the crown. Adam realizes the error of his ways and surrenders to the Justice Society, where Waller imprisons him in Antarctica. Following that, Ishmael is resurrected as a demon named Sabbac, and the Justice Society is left to face him all by themselves. Learning that the only way to defeat the demon is with Adam's help, Dr. Fate releases him from captivity before sacrificing himself. As Sabbac's legion overtakes the city, Adam shows up and kills him, saving everybody. Afterward, Adam agrees to be a protector of the city and changes his ways. In a mid-credit scene, Waller tells Black Adam that he must remain in Kahndaq, and she sends Superman to talk with him. The end. Well, I'll say this, the movie wasn't horrible, but it wasn't great either. I think the best part of the whole movie was Pierce Brosnan as Dr. Fate. I mean, come on, 007. Even though he seemed to borrow a lot from Doctor Strange. But anyway, Dwayne Johnson was trying to take over DC at this point. And with the movie failing in the box office, that just didn't happen. Anyway, that was the Black Adam movie, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.